All right, so I just arrived at my customer here. It's a drop yard. Let me see if, hold on a second. Out this way. I gotta pick up this trailer, but it's so freaking close together. I'll show you. Let me go talk to this yard doctor real quick. See if he can pull it out for me. Because I can't get the crank handle. Let me ask him. Where'd he go? He's right there. He's peeing. He's peeing right there. Right where you gotta stand to crank the handle down, right? Hey, boss, that trailer's too close together right there. Can you pull it out about 10 feet for me and I'll get it the rest of the way? 100168, it's right there across.
Don't park by, I'll be over here.
All right. Why they gotta pee right next to where we're cranking the handle down. You can see it right there, a big wet spot. You gotta stand on that, pee. I never understood that. Drivers pour their pee out right by the door, or they go stand and pee on the ground where you're gonna be standing. I don't get it. There's porta potties around the corner. This guy works here all day. Why would you pee? Right there. Taking a bite on it. That one right there. That one right there, boss. To wonder if I should have asked him to pull it all the way out, because look how close and tight it is. I don't know if you can see that. No, you can't see it. I gotta get my flashlight. Hang on a second. Let me get the flashlight and show you. Because I may not be able to get it out myself, because I'm so, what I'm trying to say is, sleeper tractor is so long. Look at that. So you didn't get it out quite enough. The crank handle is going to be running into here. Looks like there's a little bit of daylight anyway. So I can pull it ahead myself a little bit. But do I have enough to get it out without my tail swing hitting? That's the question. To let that guy pull it all the way out. Get it out here in the open, see? Alright, well, we'll figure it out. Let me get the lights turned on. Doorways. Push in the brakes. like I said, I got to do we a little more room over here. Not much. I mean, I can get my shoulders in here. Like, not really. That's tight. But I can pull ahead a little bit. Crank it up. I think we can snake it out of there as well as far forward as I can get before I make my turn. Try not to hit the other parked trailers. I got them in here like sardines. Let's pull ahead a little bit. See what happens. Check the fifth wheel connection. I should have done that before I cranked it up so we don't drop the trailer, you know. It's a little bit out of order this morning. Yeah, it's good. See that? All right, airbags are picking up. We just got a short little run this morning. We're picking up this load here at French Camp Yard. And stand by, let me get my thoughts together. French Camp, California. And we gotta go to Coalinga, which I think we're going to the Harris Ranch feedlot or whatever. I don't know what kind of product we have. We're gonna get the paperwork out here in a minute. Let me get straightened out. Let's snake this trailer out first. As far forward as I can. Back it in there because I can't see. This is going to be a blind set if I have to go back where I came from to try to straighten out. Come on, you automatic. That's what I hate about this. It's one thing I hate. You don't supply power through your foot pedal. You know, if you let off the gas pedal, the go pedal, it just stops. It won't just idle through. I think we're good. I don't hear any noise, man. See, I would like to creep out of here, but this thing is like taking off like a, you know. We're clear now, it's just a matter of. Oh my god. We're clear, we're good. It's just that I would like to creep out of that hole. Similar to manual transmission, you feather the clutch out. You feather the clutch out, you just kind of get it. Once it gets a little bit of power, I mean, it's not great for the clutch, you're wearing it out, but you can do things like just smoothly creep out of the hole with a steady, slow, creepy speed. Creep. This automatic does not have that feature. All right, let's go back and look for paperwork. And match it up with the bill or the dispatch. Flashlight. I'm gonna put my lock on there. You guys are helping me. We're gonna go to, like I said, Coalinga this morning. Paperwork should be in this box, but we don't know. It's sometimes these drivers, they're good at dropping the trailer and they forget to leave the paperwork with it. No, they did. Okay. Good job, driver. Make sure it goes to the right place. And I do like the Ziploc baggie to keep it nice and dry. In case it rains. 1 gallon Ziploc baggie. The only Coalinga Harris feeders, yes. And make sure the bill numbers all match up. 39178. Looks like it's going to be hay. 31 bales of hay. Okay. That's fine, I'll agree to that. I agree to those terms. It's hay bales. No big deal. I am perfectly fine with that. No problems. I actually like to, I like loads like this that are preloaded, they're at the yard. And I don't have to go spend time at the customer trying to get loaded, unloaded, or unloaded for sure. I know I get a half of the problem today is I got to get unloaded, which takes time, but I don't have to worry about the loading part because it's been done by another driver. Wonderful. It's already got a seal on it. Check my lights. Put my lock on there real quick. Okay, that's good. That is good. Second. Okay, mud flaps are good. Super singles. Are we at, it looks like 40 feet. I forgot to check. 40 foot kingpin to rear axle. We got to double check. There is no mark on the trailer. There's a little rub mark right here. But where we're going, I don't think there's going to be any scales to worry about. French camp to Coalinga. It's just straight down I-5. It's about 150 miles, more or less. No worries. Not worried about it one bit. All right, let's hit the road. Let's do this. And my lights are good, yes. And we're ready, man. Let's do it. Let's go make that money. Machine. I'm back to work. I've been off work for about, I lost count. Been off work for days. I think what happened was I got here, today's Monday, I got here last Saturday, back in my hometown, Saturday, where I got to Riverbank, California. This is like south of Stockton River where we're at. I live in Stockton. So we had to deliver a load to Riverbank. We got there Saturday, but they were closed. I'd like to get us in my message. Arrive at Shipper, which is, now we gotta do a load of cars. Some paperwork. We got down here Saturday, and they were closed. So I dropped the trailer here at the yard. I bobtailed to the house for the rest of Saturday and Sunday. Deliver my load first thing Monday morning, drop the trailer back here, and then went bobtail home for the rest of the week. Loader call, bill of lading number, put all this information in here. I'll keep that bag for in case I have to do a T-call. This is what's called a terminal call when you pick up a load at the terminal. T-call. Function is number 39178. Okay, load number is have a load assignment, do I? No, I do not. This is not a load assignment. This is a pre-plan. 6923. So I have not been dispatched on this load yet. So 100168. Send. So let's do this. They used to have accept pre-plan macro in here. Pre-plan commitment. 096. 6923. Oops. Are you committed to the pre-plan? Yes. Send. Yes. So, probably, somehow we have not been dispatched on this load yet, so if I take it, make sure it's pre-plan commitment. Probably what's going to happen, you know, because I set my load of call in already, they're going to kick it back and say, you're not, this is not your load. It's not your load, dude. It is, it will be, but it's not yet. It hasn't been dispatched on you yet. So I sent a message, commit to, I'm committed to taking it. And then at that point, they'll probably say, okay, you're dispatched. Then I have to go through that whole loaded call process all over again, which is no big deal, but I like this. I like picking up a T-call. It's easy. It's kind of like dropping a hook. Just drop it. I don't even drop. I dropped on Monday. Today's Monday again. It's been a week. Been on home for a week, dude, basically. Plus. All right, so yeah, Nathan and I had a lot of adventures. Friday had no school. We drove up to we drove over to the halfway to the Bay Area, the foothills, Altamont Pass. We did all that thing. We did some videos over there, filmed with a 360 camera on top of the car. And then Saturday morning we went up to Saturday we went up to Highway 49, other load highway. Mother Lode Highway 49. We went all the way up to Ione, California. Well, we started in Stockton, we went north up to Twin Cities, we're in the Elk Grove area, we worked our way up Ione to Jackson down, all the way down to Mariposa, and then down, back to 99, back to Stockton. I'll have to do a map, mileage thing. Filmed all that at 360, but we got a couple of rain squalls in there that messed up and pulled the camera down. The camera doesn't do well in the rain. And wait for the squall to pass and then get the camera back up. So there'll be some gaps in there. No big deal. You know, I was frustrated at the time, but I think it's going to work out good. It's still going to be like a 3+ hour video anyway. And it's, I've decided to. We'll do that again in a year or two, maybe next year. I'd like to go on March, April, when it's so green up here. Anyway, so what's this guy at? You coming out to check my stuff? Because I'm leaving. Oh, here he is. I will leave, dude. Loaded. Can you see the seal back there?
Good to go. If you could just pull forward so I can grab that and then you're all good. You have a good morning.
Two bub. checked out. A lot of these roads that we went on, in Patterson Pass Road and Morgan Territory Road, were roads that I filmed before, but did I film them at 360? I can't remember. So I wanted to go knock them out again. And had the opportunity, and I said, let's go, Nathan. We're going to go film these roads. There's beautiful green grass everywhere. I love the green, man. It's just therapeutic. Cathartic. Driving through that green grass. Everything around is green. And just breathe it in, and I just calm down. It calms me down. I used to do it when I was in the 90s. I remember in the 1990s. I would pick out a weekend in the spring like this, March. Actually April 1st now. I would drive up to the foothills and just soak in all the green. I mean, I don't think people understand when I say, oh, I love the green. You don't understand. I love the green of Northern California. I really do. What's the big deal? It's just green. It happens every year over there. You don't understand. It's very fleeting. Once that it turns green, and this time next month, in the 1st of May or so, it's going to start turning golden, brown, yellow, you know, it's going to be, all the green is going to turn yellow, dead grass, dry grass, and, you know, it's kind of depressing to know that it's just such a short, fleeting time that it is doing that. Oh, you know what, I got to put the address, Coalinga address. Well, I'll tell you what, let's just go down to Santa Nella. We'll get breakfast down there. I'll punch in the address and the GPS. I know how to get to Coalinga. Let's just go south on I-5. Yeah. Alright, so next stop will be at Coalinga, I think, in about 3 hours, more or less. Get this hay kicked on. License plate light flashing too. Optical illusion. Yeah, everything was working right when we did the four ways. Yeah, we're good. And it wouldn't matter. If it's not working, I'll just take it to the shop and get it fixed. That's what, you don't just hang out there and wait for a repair truck to arrive at the yard. You would take it to the shop and get it done. Unless, you know, there's judgment calls in trucking. Spring break. away from all that one.